Pulmonary nodule is a discrete area of whiteness situated within a lung field which is less than 3 cm in diameter. It is not necessarily strictly circular. It is surrounded by pulmonary parenchyma and or visceral pleura and is not associated with lymphadenopathy, atelectasis or pneumonia. The difference between a nodule and a mass is size. In general, under 3 cm it is called a nodule and over 3 cm it is called a mass. Questions to ask when you want to approach a solitary pulmonary nodule. Is the lesion solitary? Is it intrapulmonary? Is the lesion a nodule? Should be less than 3 cm and should not be linear or angular. Etiology. Neoplastic. Malignant causes are bronchogenic carcinoma, solitary pulmonary metastasis, lymphoma, and carcinoid tumors. Benign causes are pulmonary hematoma, pulmonary chondroma, and rarely primary pulmonary meningioma. Inflammatory causes are granuloma, lung abscess, rheumatoid nodule, pulmonary pseudotumor, and small focus of pneumonia, which is also called round pneumonia. Congenital causes are arteriovenous malformation, lung cyst, bronchial atresia with mucoid impaction. Miscellaneous causes are pulmonary infarct, intrapulmonary lymph node, mucoid impaction, pulmonary hematoma, pulmonary amyloidosis, and normal confluence of pulmonary veins. Assessing abnormalities. Look at the edge of the lesion. A speculated, irregular or lobulated edge is suggestive of malignancy. This is a case of pathology-proven adenocarcinoma of the lung. In the X-ray, there is a nodular opacity in the right upper zone. The margin is irregular and ill-defined. This is another malignant nodule with irregular margin. After biopsy, a diagnosis of osteosarcoma was made. This is a case of lung carcinoma. In the right upper zone, there is a lung nodule with speculated margins. Look for areas of calcification. These would be dense white, the same density as bone, and be obviously much denser than the rest of the lesion. Calcification is rare in a malignant lesion and would point you to an alternative diagnosis. This chest X-ray shows a fairly well-defined nodule in the right lung associated with calcification. Look at the nature of the whiteness. If the lesion is cavitating, the center may be darker than the circumference. This patient has multiple large nodules bilaterally. The largest is shown with a black arrow. The center of the nodule is darker than the circumference, thus indicating a cavity. Look at the old films if available. Tumors grow, and so if the lesion was present on an earlier film, compare its size. Some tumors grow slowly, but it is safe to say that if the lesion has not changed over a period of 2 years or greater, it is unlikely to be malignant. These are two X-rays of same person. showing the increase in size of a solitary pulmonary nodule. The left one A is 3 years ago, and the right one B is the film at present. Look for an air bronchogram. This is a sign of consolidation, and so would be a most unusual finding if the lesion was a tumor. Look for abnormalities peripheral to the lesion. A tumor may cause problems distal to it, such as infection causing consolidation or an area of collapse. Look carefully at the rest of the X-ray. Malignant tumors may be associated with mediastinal lymphadenopathy or bone metastasis. Now the radiographic features of these nodules will be discussed separately. Pulmonary hematoma and artery venous malformation. Radiographic features of pulmonary hematoma. It is often discovered incidentally. Typically well-circumscribed nodules or masses, usually small, either smooth or lobulated margins. Approximately 60% have fat and approximately 20 to 30% have calcification or ossification, which may be popcorn-like. Cavitation is not seen. Growth occurs but is very slow. This case is suggestive of pulmonary hematoma. There is a smooth, well-defined ovoid pulmonary nodule in the right lower zone. Correlation with prior chest X-ray from an external hospital confirms the lesion as stable over the last 3 years. Findings that are in favor of pulmonary hematoma. 1. It is a well-circumscribed nodule. 2. The margin is smooth. 3. There is no cavitation. 4. The lesion is stable over the last 3 years. Eventually, this patient had a CT scan done, unfortunately not available here, and the density confirmed the nodule as fat-containing. Along with other radiological features, a diagnosis of pulmonary hematoma was made. This is another case of pulmonary hematoma. A solitary well-marginated homogeneous radiodensity is seen in the right upper zone with focal central area of increased density within. The focal area represents calcification. Now, radiographic features of arteriovenous malformation. Pulmonary varices or dilated vessel may be apparent as a non-specific soft tissue mass, often with a relatively unusual orientation compared to adjacent vessels. More than one nodule raises the possibility of hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia. There may be cord-like bands or tubular opacities from mass to hilum, which are feeding artery and draining vein. In this X-ray, a solitary opacity is present in the right lower zone, and cord-like bands from the opacity to hilum are present. This is the 3D reconstruction of contrast-enhanced CT thorax, coronal view. There is a lobular structure with a feeding vessel, which is a pulmonary arterial branch. The draining vessel is a pulmonary vein tributary. This is another case of pulmonary artery venous malformation. Multiple pulmonary nodules are seen, some of which are associated with tubular opacities. Multiple embolization coils noted in both lungs.
Thanks for watching this video. You may like to watch other videos in this playlist. Please subscribe to our channel if you have not done yet.